12th standard, yesterday we have done notice. So now today we are going to do another part of short composition, that is advertisement. Now what is advertisement? Obviously it's clear from the name, advertising something. But advertisement which you are going to do in your board exam, advertisement is of two different kind. One is classified, other one is display advertisement. Now what is the difference? Basically classified, these both the advertisement you find in newspaper. You have seen your daily newspaper, Times of India, Tribune, especially Sunday Times. So here you will see the last page of the newspaper classified. It is completely full of classified advertisement. So what is the purpose of classified? Basically, different columns are there. Okay, just like to let, then it is situation vacant, situation wanted, then you know there are pets lost and found, matrimonial, basically matrimonial. So there are so many columns. Now why classified and display? What is the difference? The difference is this: in classified advertisement you have to pay for the word, means there is word limit. You have to pay for word. It means you are just trying to specify it, that as much as information you want to give in the classified form, you can give it. It is almost 50 words and you are paying for the word. So it is very limited and specified way we are explaining this. In display advertisement, the person can afford to pay as much as he can. Just like you must have seen many of the advertisement, classified advertisement, but in the form of display, it's just like a poster. The full page of the newspaper they are using. This is basically that they can afford it. You have seen the ads of refrigerators, you have seen the ads of motorbikes, even gyms, different. So what exactly? This is just like a poster, having the picture along with that display, and classified is limited, that you are going to explain in a limited way. Now we are having at least 9-10 classified advertisement in our syllabus, but I am just explaining one by one so that you can do accordingly, you can do the homework according to that. So first classified advertisement I am just taking one is today, that is situation vacant, and the second one is situation wanted. Now what is the difference between vacant and wanted? You know, it's obvious from the name, that means the place which is vacant. These are the ads which are given by the people who need the candidates. Okay, who are in the requirement of candidates. So they just put that ad in the newspaper that they want these kind of candidates. So situation wanted, that means you have enough number of experience, and you can say that you are qualified that much, that you are giving your own ad in the newspaper, just giving a briefing about you, what is your qualification, what you want, which kind of job you want. So situation vacant and wanted. So I'm taking about the points for situation vacant. So for situation vacant, first form of vacancy, that which kind of vacancy is there. Okay, and first thing is there, what they are, it starts with wanted, means which kind of candidate they want. They are going to tell about the form of vacancy. There's like wanted a teacher, wanted a receptionist, wanted a manager, an accountant. So which kind of vacancy it is, that is the form of vacancy. The second thing is about the qualification, what they want in the candidate. Okay, and everything should be written in the third person. You are not going to make full sentence and just saying that I am so and so, so I need this candidate. No, not like that. By putting commas, you are going to sum up the thing because you are paying for the word. So, form of the vacancy, qualification, what is required in that. Then they will tell about the age of the person, what they want in that person. Just like for receptionist, they said that wanted a receptionist so that arts graduate and around 25 years. So that age limit in some of the vacancies, they mention it. So first is form of vacancy, then qualification, then age, then they just want any of the proficiency in any of the field. Just like we said that the computer savvy person, that good fluency in English they want, and good looking. So these kind of proficiency, some of the companies, some of the agencies, some of the job profiles want. So basically that you have to mention there. Then coming to what they want in the candidates, they have mentioned after that what they are going to offer. So this is an eligible candidate will get the salary. So what exactly the salary package they are offering, that is the first thing. Then the second thing is, along with the salary, they said that eligible candidate then get this and that. So many of the companies mentioned there that residence, everything, whatever they want to give. So you are going to mention here. So I'll just sum up situation vacant. Suppose if one of the company is in the need of engineers. Okay, just like Hindustan Liver Limited, if I say this thing. So Hindustan Liver Limited want the candidates, software engineer having the qualification, BTech qualification. By putting commas you are going to write, having BTech, and that age must be around 25 or 26, and they should be computer excellent and having the fluency in English. And eligible people will get the salary up to, you have to mention in digit, 6 digit or 7 digit. You are not going to tell in detail, because that at the time of interview they do the negotiation. So that is a different thing. What along with the perks they are offering, that you have to mention. And when you are just saying in the last, interested people can contact, there you can mention the mail ID, there you can mention the phone number. Okay, this is about situation wanted, and in situation wanted the vacant, here you can find different kind of vacancies in newspaper. The people who are in need of job, they just go through the newspaper and they know it, what exactly is a requirement. So this is just opposite to that. You are going to tell about yourself. So you say that, and simply you say a person with this qualification, that you mention about the qualification. Okay, MBA graduate or NRI or anything you can mention, the person who want to settle back to the country. So they just tell about their biodata, that a doctor is in need of job, well qualified, MBBS, MD, specialized in field, whatever, said that the salary should be. Now this is your requirement. You are not asking for, you are telling about your eligibility. And that too also you say that what is your requirement. So the company or the, say that the hospital should be able to pay this and that. So interested people can contact me. So here you can mention your own phone number, your mail ID. So the difference between wanted and vacant is, this is given by the company, the organization, those who are in need of the people, and this is given by the person himself who is in need of job. But basic point which you have to keep in mind, a particular heading whenever you are starting, that is the first point, heading is required. Second thing is that there should be proper box. Okay, and third one, always third person description. You are not going to tell about that I am so and so, and no, so that don't extend the word limit. If you are given 50 words, that means you have to sum up till 50 words. So that will be according to the detail, because I am not going to take all the advertisement today. I am just summing up situation vacant and wanted. And you can do practice of that, and always remember the value point which I mentioned. Thank you so much. So tomorrow we'll do the other one.